beneath the level of storms I slept. I moved within color and music as inside a sea diamond, the caress of flow and desire mingling, touching, traveling, withdrawing, wandering.
This story. I was wrong to tell you how multi-true everything is, when it would be truer to say nothing. I've invented so much and prevented more, but I'd like to talk with you about other things. In absolute quiet, in extreme context, to see you again. Isn't love revision? It could have gone so many ways. This is just one of the ways it went. Tell me another.
Thank you. oceano. Cuerpo más puro que una ola. Sal que lava la viña. Y el ave lúcida volando sin raíces.
Portrait number 2, August 1911. I pose nude for this photograph. Awkward, one arm folded behind my back, the other limp at my side. Seated, I raise my chin, my back so straight I imagine the bones separating in my spine, my neck lengthening like evening shadow. When I see this plate, I try to recall what I was thinking, how not to be exposed, though naked, how to wear skin like a garment, seamless. Belloc thinks I'm right, for the camera keeps coming to my room. These plates are fragile, he says, showing me how easy it is to shatter this image of myself, how a quick scratch carves a scar across my chest.
I want freedom from memory. I could then be somebody else. Born again. Free in the white space of forgetting.
My first vision of Earth was water veiled. I remember my first birth in water. I sway and float, stand on boneless toes, listening to distant sounds. Sounds beyond the reach of human ears, see things beyond the reach of human eyes. Listening for lost sounds and searching for lost colors. Lost in the colors of Atlantis,
Thank you. One second before you all go, I just wanted to thank you all for coming here and sharing what has been the world premiere of Houses of Zodiac with us this weekend. And I wanted to say a little bit, I'm Ed Petuto, I'm from The Broad, I'm the Director of Audience Engagement, about the artists, these extraordinary artists. This was a labor of love for all of them. It happened during the pandemic. They literally, Dai and Gina only began rehearsing in person this week. They choreographed this across the world digitally. And what inspired us, yes. What inspired us at The Broad to bring this here to LA and to build an audience for it is the resonance it has with the Takashi Murakami exhibition across the street. And if you use your ticket, you don't have to make an appointment, you don't have to wait in line, you can go anytime between now and June 12th and see the exhibition across the street. And I want you to think about, and I'm sorry to be holding my phone, these are my notes. I want you to think about this performance and the kind of issues and spiritual things that this performance was dealing with, particularly when you're in the room with the two large paintings of the 100 R hats and Chasing the Tail of the Rainbow. There's a lot of resonance between what they're dealing with in this piece and Takashi's work. And then lastly, I just wanted to encourage you all to take home some vinyl today. The artists will be outside signing copies of Houses of Zodiac. This, you can take this gorgeous music home and enjoy it over and over and over again. And thank you again for coming.